Hello and welcome to Bite Size Med. In this video, we're going to talk about the stages of renal development. First, let's look at what we need to know in the anatomy and the structure. So there are two kidneys in the abdomen, and each kidney has millions of nephrons. The kidneys have an excretory portion and a collecting portion. The excretory portion of the nephron starts from the glomerulus, then the proximal convoluted tubule, the loop of Henle, and the distal convoluted tubule. The collecting system is the collecting ducts and tubules, which form the minor calyces, then the major calyces, the renal pelvis, which continues down as the ureter, which is going to empty into the bladder. The kidneys develop from the intermediate mesoderm, and the portions of this mesoderm that condense to give rise to the kidneys are the nephrogenic cords. There are two kidneys, so they're bilateral. They extend from the cervical end to the sacral end of the embryo. So if we assume this is the back of the embryo, it's from the neck end up to the sacral end. There are three stages of development: the pronephros, then the mesonephros, and the metanephros. They're one below the other. So the pronephros is at the cervical region. The mesonephros is between the thoracic and the lumbar region. And the metanephros is lower lumbar and sacral. The first stage is the pronephros. We're now at week 4. The pronephros is very primitive, just some cell clusters and tubules and the pronephric duct. This duct opens into the cloaca, part of which is going to form the bladder, but for now it's still the cloaca. So the pronephros can't function, it degenerates, so we're just going to remove that. And now we're on to stage 2, the mesonephros. This appears late in the 4th week. They have mesonephric tubules, which are like primitive versions of renal tubules, and these are associated with capillaries. What's that? That's a glomerulus. That means they can perform filtration, and they drain into the mesonephric duct, also called the Wolfian duct. Again, that opens into the cloaca. So this stage can perform filtration, so it's functional, and it does the work of the kidneys until the final kidney takes over, so up to around 12 weeks. These tubules, they start degenerating as well, from the top down. By the 5th week, the metanephros forms. Now this is going to form the actual kidney. It starts functioning towards the 12th week. It takes over from the mesonephros. From the lower portion of the mesonephric duct, there's a bud that grows. This is the ureteric bud. Now this is going to form the collecting system of the kidney. The lower part of the nephrogenic cord has the metanephric blastema. The ureteric bud induces differentiation of the mesoderm in this region, and that's going to form the excretory portion. First, let's look at the ureteric bud. The caudal part of the bud, that's going to form the ureter. So that leaves the cranial part to form the rest. So it branches and forms those collecting tubules. The first few set of branches will form the major calyces, and the next set will form the minor calyces. So we're done with the collecting system. We've got the calyces, the pelvis, and the ureter. Now on top of each of these collecting tubules, the metanephric mesenchyme forms a cap. This is going to form the excretory portion of the kidney. The ureteric bud induces differentiation of this cap. There's formation of a renal or a metanephric vesicle. So these vesicles, they become S-shaped. And one portion of this S gets associated with capillaries. So that's going to form the glomerulus. The rest of the S becomes the renal tubule. They lengthen and they form the proximal convoluted tubule, the loop of Henle, and the distal convoluted tubule. So we finally got a nephron. So the ureteric bud induces the metanephric blastema, and that in turn induces the ureteric bud. So the ureteric bud forms the calyces, the renal pelvis, and the ureter, so everything from the collecting duct downwards, and the metanephric blastema forms the excretory portion from the glomerulus to the distal convoluted tubule. As gestation continues, the number of nephrons increase, because ultimately the kidneys have millions of nephrons, remember? So the kidneys have developed in the pelvic region, but the kidneys ultimately are going to be in the abdomen, and that's because with body growth they ascend. So initially, their blood supply is from branches of the abdominal aorta, but finally, the renal arteries come directly off the abdominal aorta. So during fetal life, when the kidneys function, they form urine. That drains into the cloaca and then into the amniotic fluid. And that is how the kidneys develop. Three stages: pronephros, mesonephros, and metanephros. If this video helped you, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.